Not bad for a boy from the Imperial Barracks, eh?
If you're desperate to know more about Walud, Vivian's your girl. But if I were you, I'd be heading straight to my bed.
It's good to have you back. I was worried. I know what you're going to tell me. Thank you, Clive. Thank you.
When it comes to boyish charm, Gooks has an indomitable rival in Gav. One is the sweet little babe in arms to be cooed over. The other, the naughty little boy who'd pull on my pigtails.
Let me know if you find any books worth reading.
Oh, we've hundreds of them in the shelves. Why don't I show you round one day?
I think Mid might need some help tidying up that workshop.
Mid might need well-meaning souls to leave her alone. She has it how she likes it.
Lovely breeze, isn't it?
Sitting here, eating good bread, in good company. Can life get any better than this?
I hear you've been busy making friends, Sid. Your predecessor had the same idea. Why, he even extended the hand of friendship to me. Not once, but twice.
Oh, catch your death sleeping out here.
I know. I'm too full to move.
Come up with something soon.
Editors, I knew it was a good idea to have editors study alongside the children. It's really stoked their competitive spirit.
I have done it, Sid. I have learned all the letters, every one.
Hasn't been her usual self lately. Hardly ever see her with a smile. She's always down in that dungeon of hers, muttering away.
I went up to give some greens to the chocobo, and do you know what it did? Only went and bloody bit me.
Could be nasty. You should ask Tyre to have a look at that.
Thank you. Sid, thank the Founder you have returned safely. That's one weight off my mind.
Eat up, little ones. There's plenty more chocobo manure where that came from.
You'll never believe this, Martel. Cook was dead. Sid did it.
To grow as tall as you, Mr. Stelts.
Back, are you? What's that for you, dear? You can thank me later. Do my best work, but it'll do.
Back soon.
Is it business or pleasure?
Coin purse weighing you down? I'm thankful you got that much.
Knowledge is yours. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Always welcome, Clive.
Oh, I'm never drinking again, no matter whose funeral it is.
The sun hath taught the mountain. Oh,
bid welcome to the morning and fizz of night.
The nobleman who visited. Was that really Sid's uncle?
It was. And I hear he filled our coffers to bursting.
What can I get you, Sid? As if setting our people free wasn't enough. Good news, everyone. The casks have been liberated. Here's to Sid. Oh, keep your mug handy.
Came of Cooker. Why haven't we heard anything?
I'm sure we'll hear something soon.
We're seeing troops amassing at every border crossing.
Well, no surprises there. It was the same after Drake's breath.
It was luck, and luck alone. But now, thank you, Clive. Quick look. Always something in there.
Conquering hero returns, and with hardly a scratch on him.
I may have picked up one or two.
Well, the fact that you came straight to me instead of visiting our resident physica suggests that you picked up something more important. A scent. The scent of Waludas.
The very same. But whatever plans Kupka was hatching with the Royalists, he took them to his grave. As did his men, slaughtered by the orcs who'd taken over the Fang. Orcs, Vivian. I've never seen such creatures in Storm before. The Waludas must have ferried them over from Ash, but why? Why work to rescue Kupka only to invade his home, the mother crystal of an allied nation, and let both fall? It makes no sense.
Do you know the tale of the blind men and the Adamantus? One can often be led astray by focusing too closely on individual details. One must instead see the bigger picture. And what bigger picture is there than my map? The Kingdom of Walud claims dominion over all of Ash. It is a nation forged by the bloody conquest of Barnabas Tharm, the dominant of Odin. The Canvarian War of Independence in 849. The Battle of the Twin Realms in 865. The Battle of Belinus Tor in 873. Wheresoever his armies fought, Odin was found where the fighting was fiercest. But of late, the warrior king appears to have laid his sword to rest. Battle rages for control of the crystalline dominion. Yet Tharm sends not a single ship in support of his Dalmechian allies. Meanwhile, the Blight ravages great swathes of Ash. Yet warlike Walud shows not the faintest interest in laying claim to untouched lands. So why go to the trouble of sending an army of orcs into the heart of Drake's Fang, only to make no attempt to claim the Mother Crystal for Walud? It can hardly be for lack of men. Tharm's armies rival any in the Twins. No. We have not seen the last of the Waluda standard. Odin will ride again. It is but a question of when. And on that day, who will be trampled underfoot? In summary, I know not to what end the Royalist betrayed Kupka. I know only that it is part of some broader scheme. A scheme tied to the ambitions of one man.
King Barnabas.
But there is no need to wallow in confusion. If one is to cure a sickness, one must first identify the symptoms. And your Lord Uncle has volunteered to do just that by keeping an eye on the Royalists' movements.
He's really throwing himself into this.
Indeed he is. Which means all that remains for us to do is await his reports. Well, not quite all in your case. The people of the Hideaway must hear the news. Justice has been done. Hugo Kupka is dead. The wounds he left that night are still raw. Especially for those who lived with Sid the longest. Tell them that those wounds might finally begin to heal. Consider it the price of today's instruction.
I've never known you to be sentimental.
What can I say? I am only human. And we are, all of us, sentimental animals at heart.
I suppose we are. Very well. I'll go and spread the word.
And how may I assist you today? So what if it's Parliament? Which leaves but one man. How may I help you today? Here you are. Once more? Very well. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
That bastard Shadow loomed over us all for far too long. Thanks for snuffing him out, Clive.
We've seen troops amassing at every border crossing.
Three down, two to go. It's the same. Where next, Sid? The tail or the spine?
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper.
Kupka. But when I close my eyes... Only I don't know how. I wish you were here.
Your benefactors are a generous lot.
I know what you're going to tell me. Thank you, Clive. Thank you.
Gav told me the gentleman who visited earlier, the one with the loud voice, was your uncle. I did think there was a resemblance. Something in the eyes.
It's good to have you back. I was worried.
Clive, have you come seeking the gift of knowledge?
No. To share mine, actually. Hugo Kupka is dead.
Oh, my. Can it really be true?
Look, he's crying. He is. The big baby.
And with good reason, children. These are tears of joy. We must offer up a prayer to your parents that the heavens might weep with us. There shall be no lessons today, only thanksgiving and merrymaking. Go, put away your things.
All right. Brilliant.
Finally, a new dawn has broken.
It has.
Thank you, Clive. I cannot wait to share the good news.
Hippocrates, after Kupka fell, Ultima came to me. I need to know what he is. Have you learned anything?
Alas, no. And not for want of trying. I have scoured nigh every historical tome in our collection and found nothing. Not even the sort of conspicuous absence that might suggest a concealment of fact. One is almost tempted to conclude that such a creature never existed.
But I saw him. With my own eyes.
I don't doubt that you did. Alas, it seems you are the only one who has. To others, he reveals naught. We see only that which he leaves in his wake. Like some terrible force of nature beyond the ken of mortal man.
A bringer of death.
Whether the Ultima you met with was the being itself, or merely another projection of its power, I know not. But until I do, my investigations shall continue.
Thank you. It means a lot.
Is there something I might assist you with, Clive? Kupka is no more. I must spread these glad tidings throughout the hideaway. But fear not. Once the news has been shared, I shall, of course, resume my investigations into Ultima right away. How good it is to see you, Clive. I have said it many times. His story is ended. Were you aware? But what of the twins themselves? Yes, change will come. Kupka is no more. I must spread these glad tidings throughout the hideaway. But fear not. Once the news has been shared, I shall, of course, resume my investigations into Ultima right away.
nobleman who visited?
The man who
was that really Sid's uncle?
It was.
I'm sure they're looking down on us now and smiling. To
bursting. I'm smiling too.
Yeah, me too. Thanks, Sid.
Not bad for a boy from the Imperial Barracks, eh?
Well, someone looks pleased with himself. It's true what I'm hearing, then.
Nothing escapes you, Lady Karen. It's true. Kuka is dead.
No more looking over our shoulders, then. Good. I'll start to get a crick in my neck. Don't let it go to your head, though. Well, don't just stand there gawping. It's a relief. Thank you, Clive. If you're going to buy some, be quick about it. You'll not find a better price than that. Better I'll be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better I'll be here. Finished, are you?
Blackthorn, do you have a moment?
What is it? I'm busy.
I wanted to tell you that Hugo Kuka is dead.
I can't tell you how long I've been waiting to hear those words. This is it, then. A new beginning under a new Sid.
I'll try to live up to the name. Right. Let's see if Otto has anything else for me.
Clive. To a bloody Rudence. So, will it be? Best work, but it'll do. You can thank me later.
And what can I do for you? Go on, then. Is that all?
I heard what you told Nan about Kupka. Hopefully all our old friends can rest easy now.
I went up to give some greens to the chocobo.
Editors started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
When it comes to boyish charm, Goops has an indomitable rival in Gab. One is the sweet little babe in arms.
You barely sat down since you came home. Vivian got you running errands or something. Just spreading the word. So, the professor's got a soft side, has she? I'd never have guessed.
No. She was right, though. Everyone was glad to hear the news.
Ah, but you ain't told everyone. I can think of plenty of friends back at the old hideaway who'd sleep more peacefully for knowing. Not least of all Sid. You should tell him.
You're right. I should. And I will.
Well, when you do, be sure to take Mid with you. She's been going at it hammer and tong down in that workshop of hers, trying to do her father proud. But I can't remember the last time she visited the old sod's grave.
Very well. I'll suggest it.
Fancy a look at the list, do you?
Here you go. Always something in there.
Soon.
All right, Clive? What do you want?
I'm going to visit Sid, and I thought you might like to come with me.
Sorry, I'm too busy for all that right now. I've got to get this thermal displacement stack sorted.
Thermal...
displacement stack. Here.
And this is for...
Only the fastest... finest ship the world has ever seen. The Enterprise. Me and my dad designed it together. Where other vessels rely on the fickle winds to drive them through the water, ours is fitted with mithril engines. And those things have got more push than a behemoth in a bad mood, and more heat than all the hells put together. which is where the stat comes in. I may have already talked some tight-lipped shipwrights into putting the hull together for me in a little dockyard in Canver. But the stack's a bit more involved, so I'm building it here. Thing is, it's so involved that I'm running behind and it's starting to hold things up over at the shipyard. I'll come and see my dad, though, when I'm done. Whenever that is.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Good old Clive. I were hoping you'd say that. First things first, I need some parts mech-in. The stack will be made up of three major components. There's the plating, here, that channels hot vapors away from the engine. The helm over the top, that disperses all that heat into the air. And the shielding around the sides, that stops the rest of the ship from going up in flames.
A full suit of armor, then. Probably best to take it one piece at a time.
Then you'll need to start with the plating. Everything else fits onto it. I've got the designs and the list of materials here. Show these to Blackthorn. He'll know what to do.
Well, I can't make head nor tail of them.
Luckily, you don't need to. The engine plating's basically just a very efficient conductor. Create a thermal gradient across it and the heat radiates outwards, which... You know what? Just show the plans to Blackthorn. He'll know what to do.
Editors started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
It hasn't been.
Blackthorn, can I ask a favor?
Out with it.
It's for Mid.
This my last chance to say I'm otherwise engaged. I'd spare myself for your sake. Go on then. What is it this time?
She said you would know. Here.
You'd want this for, but I can make it. Won't be easy, though. And I'll need help. Get Gavin Otto in here, will you?
All right.
So Mid's roped us all in here again, has she? Typical. Still. If that's what it takes to get her to visit Sid's grave, I'll do what I can.
And, what is it we need to do, exactly?
Take a look at this. It's this plating. The usual saw grade steel won't work. We need something that can get very hot, very fast, and still keep its shape. That means an alloy. Something that won't break or buckle at the temperature she's talking about. Which is where you lot come in. I need materials, and I've got my work cut out already. You'll have to fetch them. Now, there's a special kind of sand I'm after that you can only find out in the Valcroy. Stardust, they call it. As for the rest of the stuff, my usual supply should have it in stock. It just needs buying and bringing back here.
Well, we'll get it done quicker if we split up. One of us should probably give you an uncut in the sand.
And the other can go and get the rest from this supplier.
Right then.
Well, make your minds up who's going where, and we can get this over with.
Up to you who you take to the desert. I mean, Gav's going to fight. You don't have my winning personality.
Ah, don't listen to him. You'll be in the lowest of low company with either of us.
Going after the Stardust, then, are you? Which one of these two lucky souls is going with you?
Otto, you're with me.
All right, then. Where do we find this stardust, and how will we know it when we see it?
There's a river that runs through the southern reaches of the Velcroy. It's the black sand that washes up on its banks that you're after.
And I'm guessing you'll be needing sack loads of the stuff. Might be worth our importers at the Dalimil Inn. I'll head down there. See about finding us a wagon.
All right. I'll meet you by the river.
You two take care, eh? I'll go and see the supplier.
Just don't let the bastard fleece you, eh?
He wouldn't do that. He's Blackthorn's mate. Isn't he?
Best of luck.
Don't you worry about me. I can smell a swindle from half the twins away.
I'll head down to Dalimil, see about hiring us a wagon. Wait for me by the river.
He cracked the crystal too? You're joking.
It's no joke. Drake's Fang is gone. There's nothing left but a crater.
Good day to you, Sid.
It's all but spent. What do we do now?
The crystals.
And we had to dig a new cellar.
Ah, Clive. Your timing is exquisite, as always. I have a concern which you may be able to assist me with.
Go on.
There are whisperings afoot of shadowy figures having been sighted outside the village. Rustlings in the undergrowth, suspicious noises. My people fear that they are being watched. It may be no more than a surfeit of nerves, understandable in the current climate, or it may be the prelude to something altogether more dangerous. Given what I hope you'll forgive me calling your nose for trouble, I wondered if you might investigate.
Of course.
Excellent. You might begin by speaking with the good citizens of Lostwing. Listen to their tales, and make what you will of them.
All right. I will.
My people speak of strange shadows glimpsed in the gloom of the woods. Either these are figments of anxious imaginations, or someone is out there, someone who does not wish to be seen.
Right. Let's see what the people of the village have to say. I'd better find out if this is just nerves, or something we need to take more seriously.
You all right, Sid? Something on your mind?
There is, actually. Can I ask you something? Quentin tells me people have mentioned shadowy figures out in the woods. Have you noticed anything unusual?
Oh, that. No, sorry, can't help you. I heard the rumors, mind, from the lads working over at the vineyard, but none of them have seen anything either.
All right. Thanks anyway.
Don't know who the lads heard the story from, but it's going all around the village. Shadowy figures lurking in the woods that disappear as soon as you spot them. Oh, it's enough to send a shiver down your spine just thinking about it.
You're quite talented with that rod of yours.
I've caught my share of it.
Do you have a moment? There's talk of suspicious figures in the woods. Have you seen anything out of the ordinary?
No, but I've heard something. Sound of scraping metal, like someone sharpening a sword.
Where was this?
In Lorbert's Pass. Was out foraging for herbs when I heard it. Screeching out from between the trees. Ran back here as quick as my legs would carry me. And I ain't been back since.
I see. I'll look into it. Thank you.
I was in Lorbert's Pass when I heard it. Sounded like someone whetting a blade. Ready to slit my throat. Put the wind right up me, it did.
Seems Lorbert's Pass is our best bet, then. What do you say, Torgal? Shall we go and investigate? Good girl. You there.
Fuck! He's seen us. Get them before they escape!
Black Shield. Here. What are you doing here?
What is it to you? Not that we give a damn. All that matters to us is that you don't leave here alive.
Why were they here? Were they planning an attack on Lost Wing? I need to warn Quentin.
Good day to you.
Clive, how goes the hunt for our sinister figures?
I found some black shields hiding near Lorbert's Pass. They're gone now.
Black shields. The Empress's former bloodhounds. Though they serve another master now. One who means to root out and destroy both me and those I care for. And it would appear the pack has finally caught the scent of its prey. Damn it all. I had hoped I would have more time than this. More time to prepare. But if we are cornered, we have no choice but to bite back. And bite back we shall.
I'm sorry. You're going to need to explain. Who did the Black Shield serve now? And why would that person want you dead?
Because I want him dead.
Who?
The former Lord Chief Justice of Sanbrek. All that I have built here is for him.
I don't understand. Why him? Why Lostwing?
I suppose it is better that you know the truth. I was a member of the judiciary once. So sickened was I by the injustice of this world, I swore to fight it. And fight it I did, in my own small way. I saw more than a few corrupt officials condemned to the very cells into which they had thrown blameless innocence. Men to whom the law was but a scourge to turn against the powerless. And throughout, it was the Lord Chief Justice who backed me, who was my one true ally in the quest to see justice done.
So what changed?
I discovered that he hunted bearers for sport. I was a fool to think he shared my hatred of venality and vice. His support for me was no more than a facade, a means of ridding himself of his rivals, a mask to hide the rot beneath. I filed suit against him immediately. His response, however, was rather more visceral. He had my entire family slaughtered, and he faced no punishment whatsoever. I lost everything. My loved ones, my livelihood, my position, the faith I had once held that any modicum of justice might be achieved through the courts. So I set about enacting my own. I tracked down every soul who served him and slit their throats myself. But the man himself proved an altogether more difficult target. With money and power come protection. And so I saw that I would need an army of my own. I came here to Lostwing and began recruiting like-minded individuals.
And everyone here knows this is why you do what you do.
Of course. They too have lost loved ones to the bearer hunts. Seen faultless friends sent to the gallows to spare the guilty. All under the watchful eye of the Lord Chief Justice. Our wounds are the same. And our cause is the same. We are comrades. And our revenge is already in motion. We know where he hides, how numerous and well-trained his guard. What we did not know until now, however, was that his plans may already be in motion, too.
Quentin.
Our time is short. He may move against us at any moment, unless we move against him first. My friends and comrades, it begins. Make ready for war.
To change his mind.
What can I interest you in today? Yes. I trust it's all here. I hope it's to your liking. You're all always welcome here in Lostwing.
That his lordship's vultures should be found circling the village can mean only one thing. That he means to strike at us before we can strike at him. There is no time to lose. The final stage of our plan must be put into motion.
If you're ready, we leave at once.
Taking you all to a storehouse in the Bales. Leave anything you don't need behind.
My blade yet hungers, and so do I. Come, let us feast on your flesh. Your feasting days are over.
Over here! Help me, boy.
Those who kill for sport deserve no better.
Where would I be without you?
You deserve a rest.
A mountain of a monster, twice as tall as Titan himself, cracked the fang open like it was a sparrow's egg. I swear, on my grandmother's grave, I saw it myself.
Another crystal. The mines. It's all gone.
Lord Kupka's castle too. Do you think he made it out alive?
Faster!
to fight.
Be safe. That wasn't too bad, was it, Torgal?
Good girl.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Deserve a rest. Let's go.
Faster.
To the stables, girl. Safe.
Yeah, Corvo!
go.
I take it Drake's Fang was your doing, Cid. You really are quite the outlaw. It's only a matter of time before the people learn of this and seek to apportion blame. Lie low is my advice.
Master Lubor says Drake's
Our hero returns. That was your doing, was it not? As for me, stay safe out there.
I'll make a master smith of myself someday, and hopefully make myself useful to Master Lubor someday sooner.
Crystal gone. What are we gonna do?
Calm yourself. We don't know for sure. It could have just been a tremor.
Some of them are still living among us. You could be one of them. I could be one of them.
Back again, are you? Any more trouble and you'll be barbed for life, however deep your friends' pockets might be.
Take a sniff, good sir. You'll be transported.
Leave now. There'll be no one to man the shop. Gone, just like that. And without so much as a by your leave.
What's the matter?
It's my apprentice. He up and vanished while my back was turned. I'd go and look for him myself, but I've got a bakery to run. A bakery that's now short one pair of hands. Loath though I am to rely on the kindness of strangers, I'm at a loss. Please, will you see if you can find him?
I'll see what I can do. Do you know where he might have gone?
I wouldn't be surprised if he was off somewhere mooning at Drake's Fang. He used to work there, you see. Poor fool left his heart in its hollow.
All right. Then that's where I'll start.
Huh.
can't say I understand that boy's obsession with the Fang. I can't say I understand much about him at all.
Good girl. Straight home now. Excuse me.
What do you want?
The baker sent me to find you.
I am a sorry, selfish sod, aren't I? Certainly not a baker. Master must rue the day he took me in. Time was the sight of the Fang used to calm my nerves. But now look at her.
I take it you missed the Mother Crystal.
I hated her. But she was all I knew. Worked her mines for years. And when she shattered, part of me shattered with her. I had to trade my pickaxe for a rolling pin. But I'm no good at baking. Every loaf I touch collapses. My bread's as hollow as I am. She was the only thing that could fill the hole inside me. Oh, I loved her, damn it. But now she's gone. She's never coming back. What am I supposed to do? I ask her. How does a shell of a man learn to live again?
Perhaps you could express yourself in your work. If you miss the Fang, maybe you could recapture it somehow.
Recapture it? I'm a baker, not a... You know, you might just be right. What a fool I've been! I have to get back to the bakery right away. Thank you! Thank you, my friend! You've opened my eyes!
Wait. Suppose you won't be needing an escort then.
Take a sniff, good sir. You'll be
Ah, there you are. The man who lit a fire under my wayward apprentice. Though I worry you might have stoked the flames a little too high. He damn near ran me down trying to get to my oven.
Master, it's ready. Behold the Drake's Balm. A truly unique creation.
I dare say it is.
Just look at it. A perfect likeness of the Fang herself. Her steepled peaks, her fulsome spurs, her inviting hollow. True, my loaves collapse more often than not, but what's the Fang without her crater? Why, no Fang at all. And look, inside. She's filled to bursting with a bounty of beautiful crystals. Salt crystals! Master, I have found my purpose. I must use my work here to preserve the memory of the Fang?
Well, if it tastes off as unique as it looks, I'd certainly say you're on to something. Not only is my apprentice back, but he's finally pulling his weight. With any luck, I might even have a new delicacy on my hands. I don't know how you did it, but you have my thanks. Now, Dusan, I know you're keen, but do you have to use the good salt? Leave some for the rest of us.
Sorry, Master. I'll go and get some more later.
It would make a fine gift.
Looks like I found the river. Now, where's Otto?
I had a quick scout about him, and I reckon this area is our best bet. Seems Blackthorn's the only one who thinks smithing with his stardust stuff's a good idea. He's just lying here, waiting for any old fool to fill his boots.
But unlike any old fool, you thought to bring a wagon.
Well spotted. Now get filling.
Should be enough for now. Let's see how Otto's getting on.
How much did you get?
Enough.
Together, and I can't see Blackthorn complaining much. Here, Clive, do you fancy a walk? Sid would be proud.
Of what?
Of you. You idiot. The way you've carried on what he started. When we first met, I had you down as a spoiled little puppy who enjoyed nothing more than biting the hand that fed you. But 5 years on, you're the one doing the feeding. So thanks for proving me wrong.
You weren't wrong. But I changed. Thanks to Sid. And thanks to you. When I suggested taking on his name, you were the first to back me. And if you hadn't, no one else would have. I couldn't have done any of this without you, Otto.
Don't give over. You're making me blush. All I did was choose hope over despair. I gave you a chance, yes, but you're the one who took it. You took a rabble of homeless, hopeless outcasts and put them back on their feet. Gave them something worth fighting for, just like the old Sid did. About time I was heading back, I reckon. All this scrabbling about in the sand's taking its toll on the old pins.
I'll see you back at the hideaway then. You can take a well-earned rest when you get there.
Oh, I plan to. Believe you me. But I'll make sure Blackthorn gets his precious black sand before I put my feet up. He'll only moan otherwise.
Right. Ready to go home, boy?
Stay sharp. We don't know when those bastards will be back.
All right, Clive. Most folk round here. So I told him everything. Reckon they'd spare you. This town is ours. Old Hill. Founder's sake. Who knows? Come back soon, eh?
The victims of the Viceroy's culling have been buried, but they will not be forgotten. We Guardians won't let this happen again.
Look, everything.
Not everything. You still have your life.
and it's up to you to decide what you do with it.
Come on.
Yeah.
Straight home now.
Much of Rosalith was lost to Kupka and his men, but the better part of it remains, thanks to you, Lord Rosfield. Your father would be proud, as are we all. May the blessing of the Firebird go with you, always.
Let's go.
Faster!
Back to the stables, girl.
Rosalith burns. And yet the Vicerain would rather her guards keep us from salvation than quell the flames. We are nothing to the Empire. Nothing but a nuisance.
I was born in Rosalith. Lived in spitting distance of the castle. I even saw the Archduke once.
Half the guards at that gate are Rosarian. They've sold their souls for the promise of a warm bed. Not that I can blame them. The Empire's left us nothing.
What happened in Rosalith? I've got family there!
You're has the castle fallen?
Go and find out!
They're gonna kill us! All of us!
That's enough of that, you!
Open the damn gates!
What if Port Isolde is next?
Not a step closer!
You have to let us in!
When the blight came to our village, we had no choice but to flee. But it seems the nobles of Port Isolde have no sympathy with our lot, and would rather we starved out here.
Let's hope this is all Blackthorn needs.
We're seeing troops amassing at every border.
You mean the Iron Kingdom?
Good to have you back. I was worried.
How'd you lot get on? I brought back all that stuff Blackthorn asked for.
There you are. Blackthorn's got his precious stardust, in case you were wondering.
Thorn, got everything you need?
Yeah, I do. Cheers for the stardust. Should be enough to be getting on with.
Nice to get out and about for once. Let's do it again sometime, eh?
I'll make a start on putting this thermal plating together, then. It'll take some time, mind. So if you've got other things to be getting on with, I could do without you breathing down my neck.
Thank you, Blackthorn. I'll let Mid know construction's underway.
Suppose we'd better be getting back to work too.
Give us a shout if you need anything.
What do you want?
And what can I do for you? Go on, then. things at all.
Started reading books that don't have any pictures in. If I don't come up with something soon.
You'll be pleased to hear that Blackthorn started work on the plating.
Excellent. One down, two to go.
So, what's next?
The helm, of course. For this, we'll be repurposing fallen scrap.
Salvage from the ruins? I thought that material was all but impossible to work.
Ah, but we don't have to.
I'm sorry.
Just so happens there's one particular ruin that's broken into exactly the right shape and size pieces for what we need. What's the name back there? I'll give you all details.
What's the name? Right.
Talk to her back there. You know, thingy. She'll tell you exactly which bits of which ruin we need. You just need to go and find them. Oh, Sid, is this about the helm?
Yes. Mid said I should speak with you.
I'll show you the plans then. Here you see the Mithril engine, in which Mithril is burned to generate heat. That heat is then harnessed to produce motive force. Excess heat is dealt with by means of the thermal displacement stack, which disperses it into the surrounding air. Now, were we to rely on thermal plating alone to achieve this effect, the rate of excess heat buildup would far exceed the displacement coefficient of the plating. In other words, the reactor would overheat and eventually explode. This is where the helm comes in. It connects to the plating, you see, and serves as a sort of thermal sink to absorb all that excess energy. Our experiments have shown that fallen ceramics are remarkably thermophilic. They can withstand and absorb levels of heat far above anything we are able to make today. And, not only that, they're also waterproof and immune to rust, making them the perfect material for our protective hood. Why, if sea or rainwater were to enter the reactor proper, it would vaporize instantly. The forces produced would tear the ship from stern to...
You can stop there. I understand. Mid said we might be able to use parts of a fallen ruin. Where would I find it?
Ah, yes. It's in Lorbert's Pass, near Lostwing. The thing is, well, I probably should have arranged to have the pieces we need brought here sooner. You see, a certain unwanted visitor has taken up residence there. It's no longer a matter of just walking in and taking them. It's, going to be considerably more dangerous than that.
I see. Then I suppose I'd better deal with this unwanted visitor for you. Would that help?
Oh, very much. Thank you, Sid. I'll gather my team and head there right away. We'll meet you outside the ruins.
Think me. Might need some help tidying up.
When it comes to boyish charm, Goops has an indomitable.
How may I help you today, Clive? Your benefactors are a generous lot. All yours. Come again. I may have more for you.
Ain't so bad stretching your legs once in a while. Should do it more often.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be taking you all to a storehouse in the Bales. Leave anything you don't need behind.
Ready? We leave at once. Run like the wind.
Oh, there you are, Sid. Thanks so much for coming. The, ruins are just over there, as is the creature I told you about, I'd imagine. Would you mind?
Of course. I'll be right back.
The pieces we need are in the ruins, just over there, as is the terrifying monster.
Anybody home? This must be our unwanted visitor. Time to go. Nice try.
This one.
Too slow.
Yeah.
The things I do for you, Mid.
Sid! Oh, thank goodness you're safe.
You shouldn't have any trouble now.
Indeed. Well, don't let us keep you. We'll, see that everything is transported safely back to the hideaway.
All right. I'll let Mid know you're on your way.
Your work is done, Sid. We'll take care of the rest. Let Mid know she'll have her helm very soon, would you?
Fly, Ambrosia!
Welcome. I'll be here if you need me.
Keep them pilchards nice and chilled. I won't have you spoiling another catch.
Seen troops amassing at every border
crossing. No surprises there.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot. You earned this. All done?
Recovered the material for the helm. She'll be along shortly.
Excellent. Another job well done.
And just one remaining.
Right. The shielding. This one's a bit of a bugger.
How so?
The plating's enough to stop the engines going pop, but those things will still be spitting out enough fire to set the rest of the ship ablaze. Which is why you need proper shielding. A prison for the dragon's breath that's blazing away inside. I thought a triple thick layer of tempered steel might do it. Or more of the stuff that the Fallen use, but they'd both be too heavy. The helm and the plating are bulky enough as it is. Add any more weight and the whole ship would be at the bottom of the briny before we'd even started. I need something light. But I've racked my brains and I just can't think what I'd do it.
Well, if I were in need of obscure knowledge, I know whose counsel I would seek. Harpocrates.
Tomes? Yeah, well, I'd thought of that, obviously. I've got all the details written down here. Can you take this to him, see what he makes of it?
Right away.
I've been going round in circles trying to find something sturdy enough to withstand the fire of the engines, but light enough not to sink the ship. Should have bothered old Tom sooner. If anyone knows something I don't, it'll be him.
Editor's started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
It hasn't been her usual self lately.
Harpocrates, do you have the moment?
For you, Clive, always.
Well, actually, it's for mid this time. Could you take a look at this?
Shielding for a mithril engine. Whatever will that girl think of next? What are these notes around the edges?
She has some specific requirements for the materials. The shielding needs to be able to resist extreme heat on the inside, and yet remain cool enough on the outside not to set the ship alight, while also being light enough not to sink it. As you can imagine, she's struggling to find anything that meets her needs.
I see.
I wondered if you might know of a solution, or if you might be able to search the records for one.
Perhaps it is not a different material she requires, but a different approach.
What do you mean?
Consider the lake we have made our home. Its blighted waters eat away far more quickly than fresh water or even brine, at timber and steel alike. And yet, we have made a home here from those very materials nonetheless.
We have. But Bardolph must varnish every board twice over to keep it from rotting. And Obelus complains that without a constant supply of... pitch. I see.
Early Gregorian histories speak of a preparation known as moondew. It is said to be able to resist even the most ferocious flames. Before the dragoons tamed the worms and wyverns of the realm, nobles would daub their castle walls with it in order to guard against dragonfire.
So if we could recreate it...
It might be applied to some material or other in order to provide the protection Mid requires. As to how best to apply it and to what material, perhaps Bardolph and Obelus might be of assistance. I shall speak to them and see what wisdom they might have to offer. If you would be so kind as to procure the necessary ingredients, I shall discuss the specifics of how it might be most effectively put to use with our two friends. The knowledge of the past may yet prove useful to we of the modern era.
Thank you, Harpocrates. And since you're asking others to help you, perhaps I should too.
So you need a hand, do you?
We do. I'll be heading to market for the ingredients we need. I could do some help.
and some company too.
The other can assist me in researching how best to prepare the shielding itself.
Can we count on your aid?
Always. Well, if Jill's game.
Thank you.
I am sure either of these fine young minds would prove indispensable in my research. I leave the decision as to who will go with whom in your capable hands, Clive.
Shielding that guards against even the most ferocious flames. We could have done with some of that on Drustinus.
I doubt I would have survived that place with or without it. A trip to Northreach, though, I think either of us could handle.
Shielding that guards against even...
So, Clive, have you made your decision? Who will accompany you on your little excursion?
Very well. So then, what do we need to find?
I have taken the liberty of preparing a list. Here.
White chocobo eggs? Pepio nuts? Are you sure this list is right? Everything on here seems very edible. I would have thought the ingredients would be a little more exotic.
Though these items may seem mundane, they have potent effects that are rarely exploited. Effects for which they were once highly prized. So much so, in fact, that they were harvested almost to extinction, hence Moondew's having fallen from favor. Now, of course, they can be obtained with ease. You should be able to find everything you need at the market in Northreach.
Is that so? I've been meaning to visit Northreach anyway. I'll set out now. Join me there when you're ready.
I will. Until then.
You two enjoy yourselves.
You too, Talia.
Good luck in Northreach. Try not to get too distracted from the task at hand.
Is there something I might assist you with, Clive? I have a few new notes that might interest you. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Did you learn everything you needed?
Jill.
There's talk that the glass gate flood has finally split.
Keep them pilchards nice and chilled. I won't have you spoiling another catch.
Are those Pepio nuts? You can never tell.
How goes the hunt for ingredients?
I've only just started. I'm sure everything we need is somewhere amongst all these stalls, though. Why don't we split up and see? We'll take a couple of ingredients each.
All right. What am I looking for?
How about you look for the Pepio nuts and some garlic? I'll find the other things we need. We can meet by the gate when we're finished.
Up! You'll not find a bruised pippin in the bushel!
Fresh cuts! Come and get them before they're gone.
What can I interest you in today? Ah, yes. Good day.
Buy, sell, or be gone.
If that's what you want.
Thanks for nothing.
That's everything. Let's see how Jill's getting on.
The
Did you find everything?
I did. Here.
Garlic and pepio nuts. Perfect. Now all that remains is for Harpocrates to somehow turn all this into what Mid needs to keep her engine cool. But before we head back, would you walk with me a while? Thank you for asking me to help you today. It makes a nice change.
It does. It's good to get away from all the battle and bloodshed for once. Just being here reminds me of when we were children. Do you remember walking down Market Street in Rosalith, taking in the sights and smells?
How could I forget? What with Torgal's antics? Remember how his nose would prick up at the scent of sausages? He'd go racing away and we'd have to go running after him. We wouldn't catch you now, would we, boy?
Was there anything you wanted to buy for yourself while we're here?
There was, yes. Well, sort of. Molly in the kitchens told me about a place that sells particularly good pies. Thought you might like to share one with me.
I would. Thank you.
And I saw some bread. Big white cobs like the baker back in Rosalith used to make. What do you think? I thought we might get some soup to dip it in. But then I tried a slice of the butcher's dry-cured ham, and it was just... Oh.
You're right.
Sorry. It's just... Oh, you're right. I really do feel like a child again being here with you. Clive. Is it wrong of me to enjoy this?
No, Jill. This is how life should be. And it's how our lives will be when our work is finally done. When we can live on our own terms.
I hope so. Thank you, Clive. Well, I suppose we better be getting back. I need to give these ingredients to Harpocrates and Talia. I'll see you at the hideaway.
Take care.
I will. You too.
I wonder how Harpocrates is getting on with the moon dew.
Ivan's newest dish is a...
Never drinking again.
Ah, Clive. Harpocrates has all the ingredients. We were just waiting for you.
Welcome back. I hope you two had fun while I was busy helping Harpocrates.
How's work on the shielding progressing, Harpocrates?
Well, very well indeed. And thanks in no small part to your kind assistance. I was just explaining to Talia how we might best go about preparing the moon dew. And now that we have all the ingredients, we may begin.
You can count on me. I've mixed more than a few mysterious concoctions in my time.
I'm sure you have. What about the shielding itself?
Work is underway, under the watchful eyes of Bardolph and Obolus.
Apparently, it'll be ready soon.
Thank you. All of you.
Right then. Jill, would you join me in the infirmary? Many hands make light work and all that.
Of course. Oh, and Clive, thank you. It was nice just being with you.
It appears our work here is almost at an end. A shame. I was enjoying playing the man of action for once. When both the shielding and the moon dew are ready, it will merely be a matter of applying the one to the other. Followed by a rigorous process of testing and retesting, of course. Perhaps someone ought to warn young Mid of that.
Leave it to me. Thank you, Arbocrates. Well, I'd better go and give Mid the good news then.
Crystal too.
Editors started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mid. But you'll be pleased to know that work on the shielding is underway.
You found something for it?
In a manner of speaking, Hippocrates knew of a substance that's highly resistant to heat. A coating that should provide the protection you need. He's supervising the construction and testing of the shielding as we speak.
Brilliant! I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Don't thank me. I'm just the errand boy.
Right then. Better start working out how to bolt all these bits together. To the Black Hammer!
You know, when I got into the smithing game, I thought I'd be making swords and shields, not thermal bleeding didgeridoo-dahs.
Displacement stacks.
Same difference. Whatever you call it, I ain't putting it together in here. It's cramped enough as it is. Let's take this outside. Mid, you get all the parts lined up on the deck. I'll take care of the rest.
On my way!
Oh, and bring me the biggest hammer you can find. This is gonna require some precision walloping.
It's finished! It's finally finished!
Thank fuck for that. I'll be feeling my hammer arm for weeks.
Thank you, Clive, Blackthorn, everyone. That's one down and just three more to go.
I'm sorry.
Oh, didn't I tell you? The Enterprise has 4 Mithril engines, and we'll be needing a displacement stack for each.
You don't mean...
Don't worry. Now they've got a finished one to work off, my gang in Canva can build the rest.
Good luck to them, I say. Right, I'm off to get a sling for this elbow. Any other work comes in, keep it to yourselves, eh?
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Really? That's a ship? Let's sail it around the lake!
Is that you done, then? Mid's not roped you into building the rest of the board, has she?
Mid's always been good at wrapping people around her little finger. Just wish she'd picked up some of her dad's good traits.
The Enterprise will have 4 Mithril engines, each needing its own displacement stack. So, just 3 more like this, and we'll be finished.
Is that the thing Tomes helped to build? Yeah. He said it was some sort of chimney stack.
Must be quite a fireplace.
Hugo Kupka's dead, isn't he? We don't have to live in fear of him anymore.
Welcome home, Sid.
Didn't know you had that many teeth, boss.
I can't stop smiling. Tonight we celebrate with a flagon or 7 of old Jeffrey's favorite tipple.
This had better be the lot. It's a skiff or a bloody cargo freighter.
It was good of you to help Mid. And it made a nice change for me as well. There's only so many boils a girl can lance before she gets sick of it.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Visited. Was that really Sid's uncle?
Sid! Look what the curse breakers brought back from Dalmechia. Said they were all the rage in Dalamil. Looks sort of funny if you ask me.
I'll be damned.
Have you had one before?
Something smells good. What are we having?
Bombs! And they are good. You should try one.
Hey, the bloody great hole in it. Who ate the rest?
It's supposed to be hollow, silly. Haven't you ever seen Drake's Fang?
I went up to give some greens to the chocobo.
Sid, thank the founder you have returned.
I think Mid might need some help tidying up.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Really?
What's the matter?
Nothing. Just daydreaming. Thinking about the Enterprise sailing off over the horizon to shores unknown. Searching for a land untouched by the Blight. Just like me and my dad planned. So if the worst came to the worst and every scrap of soil in the Twins turned black, we might still have a chance. That's what she was meant to be. You see, one last chance just in case we needed it. But now she's so close to being finished, I've realized I don't want her to be that. I don't want her to be just a lifeboat for us to cling to if things get desperate. I want people to sail aboard her by choice, not from the lack of it. In a world where we're not just trying to survive, but where we can actually live.
I'm working on that. And I'll do everything I can to get you what you want.
Don't you always? All right. My mind's made up. As soon as the Enterprise is fit to sail, I'm putting her under your command. Sod our plans. I'm trusting in yours.
Are you sure about this?
Something tells me it's what my dad would have wanted.
He'd be proud of you.
You were gonna visit his grave, weren't you?
I was. And you can come too now that you're... little project is finished.
Right. There's just one thing I need to finish up first. Won't be a mo.
All right. I'll let Otto know you're coming. Meet us in the mess when you're ready.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Clive, Astrix, Mid finished sending half the hideaway traipsing across the Twins, has she? I swear, that girl'd do anything to put off visiting her old dad's grave. No excuses now, though, eh?
Not quite. She said there was one final thing she had to take care of. I'm sure she'll be finished soon enough.
She said that? In those words?
She did, yes.
Clive, were you born yesterday or something? There is no thing. She'll probably be halfway to Canva by now. Oh,
Mid. I might still be able to catch her.
crack the crystal too.
Trouble with the ledgers. Shouldn't he be asking Otto for help? What could be wrong with Torgor? He seemed well enough when I last saw him. Hopefully it's nothing, but I should speak to Blackthorn just in case. I got your note. You think something's wrong with Torgor?
So you can read. Congratulations. But I didn't say I were wrong with him. I said something weren't right. He's not been eating my treats. He used to love cracking the bones from Molly's boiled brown, but now he won't so much as look at them. Didn't like him. Which is why I'm of a mind that his mind's on something else. You've not been working him too hard, have you?
No harder than usual. Is that it, boy? Do you need a rest?
What was it you said he was? A frost wolf?
That's what the Lawsman seems to think.
Then maybe this all has something to do with whatever it is that's woken inside him.
I suppose things happen different since Rosaleth. Perhaps Harpocrates knows something.
Instead of everything, you mean? Perhaps.
Blackthorn, you have a moment?
Not really, no.
This won't take long. I just wanted to ask how you're getting on. August was worried about you, and you might still be doubting your craft, even after learning the trick of that cuirass. Is there something else weighing on your mind? Perhaps sharing your thoughts might help.
That bastard's like a dog with a bone. Still, he's got a keen eye, I'll give him that. He's just, well, Karen showed me something. Something I've never seen before.
And that was?
A sword. An odd-looking thing with a single-edge blade. The metal itself wasn't anything to write home about, but fuck me. The edge on it. You could slice a man clean in two with a weapon like that, and he'd be halfway home before he even realized he'd been cut.
So that's what's troubling you?
No. Not troubling me exactly. More distracting. Can't stop thinking, how do you get an edge that sharp? It's driving me mad.
And if you knew how to do it, we could arm the curse breakers with even better blades.
That's about the size of it, yeah.
I'll see what I can find out. Sharper swords are always welcome. And we can't have our master blacksmith being distracted.
You're a soft touch, you know that. But I can't say I'm not grateful for it. Good luck, eh?
Thank you. Let's see what Karen knows about this sword. You're looking well, Karen.
What do you want? Out with it.
I want to know about the sword you show Blackthorn. Single-edged and extremely sharp.
Running around after him again, are you?
I suppose I am, yes. But I need to help him find out how to work an edge like that. It's driving him to distraction.
Little wonder, I suppose. There's not many like that make it as far as the twins, and those that do go straight into private collections. Which made it nice and easy finding a buyer.
Can you tell me who bought it? Where is it now?
You think I tell people who my clients are? Suppose you're not likely to go nicking him off me, are you now? Fine. If you stop mooning at me like that. Lord Ignac's the man you want. Delmechian bloke. Collects weapons and the like. And he's got more money than sense, which is why he's one of my favourite clients. Reckon he'll still be at the inn in Dalamil, where I left him.
Thank you, Karen.
Oh, and he's a touch eccentric, if you take my meaning.
I appreciate the warning. I need to ask you about Torgal. Something's not right with him.
He isn't ill, is he?
I don't think so. But according to Lady Karen, he seems to have lost his appetite. Which is certainly a new development. She says he's hardly been touching his bones of late, and she believes it may have something to do with what happened at Rosalith Castle.
I rather think she might be right, though not about his appetite. All canids are instinctively inclined to crack open bones for the rich marrow that resides within, and I see no reason why a frost wolf should be any different. Accordingly, I suspect it is not a lack of appetite that afflicts Torgal, but a surfeit of it. If we assume that his newfound magics require additional nourishment to sustain, it may well be that the bones Lady Karen is accustomed to providing are no longer sufficient. Frostwolves, after all, habitually prey upon far larger animals, whose bones may yield altogether different nutrients. As to where one might find a suitable substitute, some antelopes that graze the meadows of eastern Rosaria have been known to grow to a size more than double that of their lesser cousins.
I don't recall ever seeing any that large.
And little wonder. The oldest and largest such creatures rarely leave the safety of the highlands for fear of predators. The last elder antelope sighting I recall hearing about took place near Cressida, and that was long before the village was abandoned.
Even so, it seems like a good place to start.
Good hunting, Clive.
She was building a ship.
Clive, did you get my letter?
That's why I'm here.
Shh. Otto won't be listening.
Is this better?
A little. Listen, I've some bad news. It turns out the hideaway may be slightly behind in its payment to certain lenders, and it may be my fault. But I swear to the goddess, I thought I had the numbers square. Sadly, that square turned out to be more of a circle. Zero, you might say. I can straighten it out, I swear, but it's going to take some time, and I'm going to need help keeping it from Otto.
Bit late for that, I'd say.
There you are! What a surprise!
So let me get this straight. You forget to pay our lenders what they're due, and instead of coming straight to me, you get Clive to come to you. And I hope he'll dig you out of the hole you've dug for yourself. Clive, the man in charge of the place you've been cheerfully trying to bankrupt. And you thought this was a cunning plan. Why? Well, who needs paying?
Oh, just Martha. And the dame. And, well, Lady Karen. But only 500 talents.
We owe three of our most trusted friends 5 million gil.
Each. 5 million. Each. They lent us the bulk of the money we used to rebuild the hideaway, you see, and, well, I must have made some sort of oversight.
Those ledgers were my responsibility, and it was my decision to entrust them to you. This is my fault.
Do we have that much to hand? I can always ask my uncle.
No, we don't. And no, you won't. We've lightened Lord Rosfield's purse enough. After the king's ransom we had off him, he deserves better than to see our begging bowl. Besides, we'll need to learn to stand on our own if we're going to make this work.
All right. But that doesn't mean you have to shoulder the burden yourself. Is there anything I can do to help?
There might be. How'd you fancy taking these to Martha and the dame?
Rocks.
Rocks, he says. Worth 1,000 talents apiece, these are.
A little something Sid and I set aside for when times got lean. And I reckon 15 million in overdue debt probably qualifies. I just hope our associates' eyes are a bit more discerning than yours.
I'm sure they will be.
Should be me making the rounds, really. But you know how it is with this place. Orders to bark, asses to wipe and all that.
I know. Which is why I don't mind going in your place.
Go. Do you know why I only gave Master Clive here 2 star rubies?
Because you'd rather Lady Karen killed me.
Because I'd rather Lady Karen killed you, yes.
Well, I suppose this is goodbye then.
Don't worry. I'm sure Karen will understand.
Really? Do you think so?
No, I don't.
Just the man to help me out of a bit of bother, if you were mind to.
Let's hear it.
Well, it's about this alembic the chief's got me making. Lovely bit of kit, it is. Bung in a solution you want split in, and it will separate it out, just like that. Problem is, it won't always get rid of all the impurities. And with some of the stuff we need it for, that ain't good enough. Which is why I've been looking for something to filter the liquid we'll be cooking off. And that's where I was hoping you could help me out.
I imagine Ty could get some use out of this alembic too. Distilling medicines and the like. All right. Why not?
Proper job!
So what exactly do you need for this filter?
Nothing but bomb ash'll do, says the chief. Gave me a sample she'd obtained from the university stores. Couldn't believe my eyes. You pour the blackest blight water through it, and it comes out clear as a mountain stream. So, I did a bit of reading about where I might be able to get hold of some. And do you know what I found out? It's only the blimmin' bones of a bomb, King. They leave them behind when they die, see?
I take it that's where I come in.
If you wouldn't mind. I saw a billet on the hunt board for one just the other day. Would have gone myself, but, well, fighting dirty great balls of flame isn't exactly my forte. You, on the other hand.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you kindly. And a good hunting, eh? I've tried to find a supplier for this stuff, but it's rare as chocobo's teeth. Either someone brings down a bomb king and picks up the ash, or... I don't know. We wait for one to snuff it of old age.
Told me she was building a ship.
Is that the thing Toes helped?
Obelith, have you seen Mid?
Yep. In a boat, going that way.
Then I'm too late.
Oh, you in a hurry at all, are ya? Oh, I offered to take her across, but she wouldn't wait. Just paid for a dinghy and rowed off. Oars going like the clappers. Got some life in her, ain't she? But anyway, I was on my way up to see you, as it happens. Got a letter for you. Urgent, by the sound of it. One of your uncle's men said I was to hand it to you in person, post-bleeding haste. And you're here now.
Thank you, Obelith.
Don't mention it.
What tidings, Uncle? Troubling Canva. Well, I'll need someone to keep an eye on Mid.
So what? Mid got us to do all the dirty work and then just sailed off into the sunset?
It seems that way.
Well, nothing we can do about it now. But next time you plan on visiting Cid, you might want to tie her to something before you suggest it.
Ah, oh, don't be so hard on her. Gotta admit, the dirty work was kind of fun. Everyone pitching in, all that bollocks. Just like when we built this place.
You're right.
Anyway, we all set to head to the old hideaway. I could do with getting to Canva pretty sharpish. Wouldn't do to keep Lord Rosfield of the Seven High Houses waiting now, would it? Not after he asked for me personally.
Gav will be leaving with me. Will you mind the place while we're gone?
You can count on me. Just be sure to give Sid and the others my regards. All right.
Oh, by the way, Jill will be joining us too. She's got some things to take care of, but she'll meet us there.
I hope she's telling the truth at least. Sid, I remember what you told me. But if no one is listening to what you have to say, you may as well not say it. But I will say this, old friend. Hugo Cooker is gone. His shadow looms over us no longer.
It's a pity the Phoenix can't be in two places at once. If it had been with us, maybe he could have done something for the Lost.
Not even the Phoenix can bring people back from the dead. Life has a beginning and an end. So we must live while we have the chance. As slaves to the crystals, but as free men.
May we join you?
Lady Karen, what a pleasant surprise.
I thought I'd drop by and see how you were all doing before heading off to restock my supplies. It wasn't the most scenic view back then, but it were never as bad as this.
I know. The Blight marches on. And soon, there'll be no escaping sights like these.
So our mission remains unchanged. We cannot stop until every Mother Crystal is gone, and their thirst for ether with them. The only one that remains in storm is Drake's Tale in the Crystalline Dominion.
Our next target.
We're going to Twinside.
It's the capital of the Empire these days. I wouldn't like to think how tightly guarded they've got the place. Not that that'll stop you. But we do well to scout it out before you go charging in.
We would indeed.
If you're off to the Dominion, you can take this great lump with you.
Goots.
Oh, I am sorry. Have you forgotten you're the most wanted man in the Twins? I thought you might like to disguise yourselves as the attendants of a travelling trader, assuming you've no better ideas. You wanted to buy yourself some tools, didn't you? Well, now's your chance.
You're letting me go with them? Oh, thanks, Nan!
Stop that! You'll break me bones, you great galoot! There's a caravan that runs back and forth between the Dominion and the Bocklab markets. It's managed by the Merchants Guild. Just show them Goots' traders pass and you'll be on your way. It'll be a damn sight less risky than footing it the length of the Crystal Road. That's for sure.
Thank you, Karen. And glad to have you with us, Goots.
Okay then. I'll get me things and I'll meet yous there. See yous down in Bocklad.
Get off! Me poor fingers!
Jill, you're with me.
Understood.
And Gav?
Already on my way, Captain.
Be careful.
Aren't I always?
Do you see that, Sid? Your protege's making a proper little outlaw of himself.
How are you feeling?
Better. Thanks to Talia.
I'm glad to hear it.
And Torgal helped too. Didn't you, boy?
Be safe. Thank you.
Clive, we weren't expecting you.
I wasn't expecting to be here. But it seems we still owe you a considerable amount of coin for your help with our rebuilding efforts. And though I doubt it's what you were expecting, we were hoping you'd take this as payment.
A star, Ruby? I can't accept this. It's worth at least twice what you owe me. More if you can find yourself the right buyer.
Think of the difference as interest.
Interest? If word got out I charged that much, no one would ever borrow from me again. Anyway, why are you the one here asking me about this? I'd have expected Otto. Bit much sending the Lord Marquis out to sell your debts, isn't it? The old goat working himself to death again.
Something like that. Most days I think he's the only reason the hideaway's still standing.
Same as always, eh? Back when the place was nothing but a twinkle in the eye of a recently retired Lord Commander, word is he was the first ones he'd reached out to. Probably knew that without his strong arm and level head, the idea would never get off the ground. Sid may have been the face of the hideaway, but Otto's always been the backbone. And when Sid passed away, we were all worried that would be the end of it. That Otto would just give up.
His death was hard on everyone. But it must have hit Otto hardest of all.
But he didn't give up, did he? Quite the opposite, in fact. If I recall, he was the one who nominated you as Sid's replacement and rallied the rest around you. I reckon what he saw in Sid, he saw in you too. And don't we all? Doesn't hurt that you're half as stubborn and twice as handsome, neither. That, and you keep good company.
I suppose I do.
Ready, go?
Faster!
Need to ride from here.
Thank you.
can walk from here. Your reign is over. Now to collect the ash. I should probably have brought a bucket. This looks like the stuff. Let's see if there's any more. That should do it. The wine needs more than this. He can fetch it himself.
There's two.
How the hell is anyone supposed to...
Thank you.
did you hear?
The gates to heaven.
I want to see you.
What am I going to do without Sweetwater and olive talc?
Still no caravan.
M'lady, I come bearing gifts.
Gifts? Whatever is the occasion. Oh, my. Clive, you really have outdone yourself.
Otto asked me to give it to you. To settle the hideaway's debt with the Veil. And to compensate you for the time it took us to do so.
Oh, you disappoint me, Clive. I thought you might finally be warming to me. Tell Otto he can keep his baubles. I tried to tell him as much the first time around. The man owes me nothing, nor does the hideaway. My contribution to the restoration effort was made freely and willingly. It was the least I could do.
You once told me Sid did you a kindness. I'd like to do the same. Please, accept it. For my sake. And for Otto's. For all of us. For all you've done.
It is rather fetching, isn't it? Very well. Otto is lucky to have you, Clive. I doubt anything could ever replace his son. But you and the others at the hideaway are the closest thing he has to family.
Otto had a son.
Long ago. Yes. Sid told me Otto lost him when he was just a boy, and blamed himself for not being able to stop it. I don't know how it happened, whether there was anything he could have done, but it was clear that it weighed heavily on him.
I didn't know.
How could you have? I doubt anyone did. Besides Sid, I've never met a man more keen to bear his sorrows in stoic silence. An ill habit, given that both have always been surrounded by friends desperate to help them.
I'm beginning to see that. Go will want to know the stones were delivered, if he's still with us.
Give my regards to Otto, and tell him I do so miss his visits.
Time was there were great coin sacks swinging from every belt in town. Not anymore. Since the capital moved, they're all shriveled to the size of peas.
How have you been? Come back soon, eh?
Come on.
Well, it's certainly quiet. If I were a giant antelope, it would seem like just the place. I doubt we'll find one bigger than that. You hungry, Torgal? Enough, I wonder. I say that answers my question, which means we owe the Lawsman our thanks. You're just a big puppy, aren't you? A very big puppy. I do know you can take that with you, Torgal. Lady Karen will be relieved to hear you've got your appetite back. Come on, boy. This one has a little more life left in it. All right, then. Nice try.
slow.
Me boy.
to sleep with you.